of Nagarjuna. Mahaprajna Paramitasastra. 8 Yen Lamad. Composed by the Bodhisattva Nagarjuna and translated by the Tripitaka Dharmakarya Kumarajiva of the land of Kaucha. Under the later Tsin. Translated from the French. By Jelongma Karma Migmi Khodron 2001. Chapter Li. Elimination of the Triple Poison. First section, eliminating the three poisons. Sutra. The Bodhisattva must practice the perfection of wisdom if he envisages the following. When I have attained supreme complete enlightenment, may there be no desire, no hatred, no delusion in my Buddha field, and may even the name of the triple poison be absent, and, from then on, may all beings be endowed with wisdom so that they recognize. Good is generosity. Good is discipline. Good is self-mastery. Good is continence. Good is non-violence toward living beings. Sastra. Trivisaksaya. 1. Eliminating the three poisons from the Ketra. Question. If the universe in question here is free of the three poisons as well as the name of these poisons, why is the Buddha born there? Answer. Desire, hatred, and delusion are called the three roots of evil. These are the dharmas that have the realm of desire as their domain. When the Buddha speaks of desire, hatred and delusion, it is a question of the roots of evil belonging to the desire realm, but when he speaks of afflicted ignorance, the latter penetrates all three realms. There are Buddha fields that contain only men of desire. For these beings, the Bodhisattva here wishes that, at the time when he becomes Buddha, in his universe there will be neither the three poisons nor even the name of the three poisons. But there are also pure Buddha fields that contain only non-regressing bodhisattvas with body born from the fundamental element. They no longer have any passions but retain only the traces. For them the bodhisattva wishes that even the name of the triple poison will be absent in his universe. Some say, when the bodhisattva formulates the vow to save all beings, beings are really not all saved. Similarly here, when he wishes that in his universe there would not be the name of the three poisons, it is clear that the three poisons will still be found there and will not be exhausted. Indeed, if there were no more triple poison, of what use would the Buddha still be? If on earth there were no more great shadows, we would not need the light of the sun. As it is said in a sutra, Abhavya Sutra. If three dharmas did not exist, the Buddha would not be born into the world, and if these three dharmas are not destroyed, it would be impossible to escape old age, sickness, and death. These three dharmas are the three poisons. Finally, there are universes where beings, analyzing dharmas, say, this is good, that is not good. This is bondage, that is deliverance, etc. And they indulge in futile chatter about nirvana of unique nature. This is why the Bodhisattva hopes here that, in his universe, beings do not produce the three poisons, knowing full well that the true nature of the three poisons is nirvana. 2. Endowing the Ketra with a special wisdom. Question. The Bodhisattva hopes here that in his Buddhaksitra all beings are endowed with such a wisdom that, what is this wisdom? Answer. This wisdom is the correct worldly view. In this correct worldly view, beings say, there is generosity, there is fruit of ripening of good or bad actions, there is a world here below and a world beyond, there are arhats. Believing in the existence of good and bad actions, they approve of generosity. Believing in the existence of arhats, they approve of morality, they approve of concentration, they approve of continence. Having obtained the power of right view, they approve of non-violence toward beings. This mundane correct view is the root of wisdom free of impurities. This is why the Bodhisattva wishes here that the name of the three poisons is not found in his field. Desire is of two kinds. Bad desire and simple desire. Hatred is of two kinds. Bad hatred and simple hatred. Delusion is of two kinds. Bad delusion and simple delusion. Beings who are the victims of the three kinds of bad poisons are difficult to convert and save. Those who are victims of the three kinds of simple poisons are easy to save. When the Prajnaparamita Sutra speaks here of eliminating the name of the three poisons, it is a matter of eliminating the name of the three bad poisons. As for the five expressions, good is generosity, etc., used here by the sutra, see what has been said above in the Fankyaung chapter. Sadharmavi Pralapa. Second section, preventing the disappearance of the holy Dharma. Sutra. The bodhisattva must practice the perfection of wisdom if he wishes that, after his parinirvana, there will be neither the disappearance of the holy Dharma nor even the name of this disappearance. Sastra. Question. If even the Buddha, who is the king of the Dharma, must disappear, why should his Dharma not disappear? Answer. As I have already said above, this was a wish of the Bodhisattva, but is not itself realizable. 1. All conditioned dharmas are the result of a complex of causes and conditions. How then would they subsist eternally and not perish? The Buddha is like the full sun and the Dharma like the light that remains at the setting of the sun. Why would this remaining light at sunset not disappear? It is only because the Dharma lasts for a long time and nobody sees it disappear that it is said not to disappear. 2. Moreover, the Bodhisattva of whom the Prajnaparamita Sutra is speaking here sees that among the Dharmas preached by the Buddhas, some remain for a long time and others do not. Thus the Dharma of Buddha Kashyapa lasts 7 days. The Dharma of Buddha Sakyamuni lasts for 1,000 years. This is why the Bodhisattva makes the following wish. Although my Dharma is conditioned, I wish that it will be prolonged and not disappear, like fire that, on finding fuel, continues uninterruptedly. 3. Moreover, the Dharma of the Buddhas is the true nature of Dharmas. Now this true nature is without production, without destruction, without interruption, without permanence, without oneness, without multiplicity, without coming, without going, without grasping, without agitation, without attachment, without support, non-existent, like nirvana. Dharmata being like that, how could it disappear? Question. Dharmata being like that, all the Buddha dharmas are necessarily without destruction. Answer. Defined in this way, the true nature of dharmas is indestructible. Nevertheless, there are people who, out of false conceptualization, grasp characteristics in things, characteristics of cessation, etc., and resort to dualistic theories, believing in disappearances. But in the true nature of things there is no disappearance. 4. Finally, by practicing the obstacle-free Prajnaparamita, the